Hi everyone, happy Sabbath.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. My name is Beatrice.
And my name is Claresta, and we will be your MCs for today. Yes, B and C are back in business. And well, it is the time of year again where you take over Sabbath service. Time flies.
Yeah, where did the year go, right? I've missed everyone's beautiful faces. It's so nice to see everyone again and would be even better in person one day.
I agree. I'm feeling a little cabin fever over here. How about you, B? Where are you right now?
I'm actually in Indonesia. Good thing you asked, because today you will be seeing a lot of familiar faces from Fountain in the City over the years, who are now from all over the world, just like me.
Oh, really? Wow. I'm so excited to see. Sounds like today's program and this week as a whole has been a little nostalgic, and seems that Fountain has now gone global. I think we should change the name of Fountain in the City to Fountain Worldwide.
That's such a great idea. I agree with that. That is exactly what makes this week so special. And because we're virtual, we get to see faces we don't see very often. Anyway, let's get this service started with an opening prayer. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this time. We thank you, Lord, for the beautiful Sabbath day. And we thank you, Lord, for the fellowship and the church family that we have. We thank you, Lord, for always keeping us safe and healthy so that we may gather here together on Zoom to worship and praise you. As we worship you today, please open our minds, our hearts, and our ears so that we may listen to your words. And through this worship, through this youth program, it may draw us closer to you and we may grow in you. Fill this meeting with your presence and let us worship you in truth and spirit. We thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. All right. So, Claresta, do you know the theme for our youth Sabbath?
Yes, it's a living witness, it says there on my screen here. So from last Sunday to yesterday, to today, our friends from all over the world have sent us morning devotionals sharing their faith as a living witness.
Yes. Why do you think being a living witness is important?
Well, let's look back at the week where we got a perspective from our very own living witnesses. In day one, it was presented by Eric all the way from Germany. He was speaking about how by putting your foot forward to win arguments and rebutting every question that people ask you, it may not always be the best approach to people. However, talking to them through a lens that is inviting, like Jesus did, and showing them through an experience and journey that you can take them on rather than in writing and figures, Eric has learned over time that this is the meaning of being a living witness.
Continuing from day one, in day two was presented by Adriana from Poland. Her personal experience with Jesus drives her desire to share her faith to others, especially to her colleagues. She's not afraid or ashamed of her principles as a Seventh-day Adventist. Through that, just being herself and with her personal experience with God, she can share her beliefs to her colleagues.
Yep, and day three was presented by Sumire from Japan. She shared her experience coming to Sydney and the blessings she experienced by meeting such loving and welcoming Fountain members, as well as her story from childhood on becoming a Christian and a Seventh-day Adventist. This was ultimately through her living witnesses of her family, as well as those around her. And in day four, we heard powerful testimonies live from many of our fellow members.
And in day five was presented by Ashleen from the USA. Just like Ashleen, as a self-proclaimed introvert myself, I really relate to what she has shared on day five. She struggled to share her experience and testimony in campus ministry or just to talk to people in general. But through the power of the Holy Spirit and prayers, she realized the blessings from sharing, that it gives people the energy to do the same, because when she opens up to other people, they will also open up to her. Not only that, the support and the solidarity that she can find through sharing.
And day six was presented by Rita from Shanghai. She experienced spiritual growth not only through Bible studies, Bible youth camps, and fast class, as some of us know, but also personal testimonies. Through faithfulness and friendships, she was shown what it is like to be a true follower of Christ. From this influence in her time in Sydney, she's taken her knowledge and witnesses to her church in Shanghai, where Rita continues her work for God.
And just earlier today, Day 7 was presented by Brian from Perth, Western Australia. He shares the importance of being transparent with God about the experiences we have in our lives so that God can utilize us as a living witness to the end of the world.
So as you can see, being a living witness is different for each person and has a ripple effect that sometimes we don't even know how far our influence has reached. So today we'll be hearing from our very own living witnesses, our speakers, that are much closer to home than we think.
Okay, all right. Now it's time for our first special item, and it is presented to you all the way from France. Do you guys know who it is? You guys might have guessed it. It is Kevin. I remember Kevin, and Kevin has always just brought his energetic spirit into Fountain every single week.
Oh, Kevin. Miss Kevin. And yes, he was very funny and spontaneous. You never know when he's going to become a human flag. Not sure if anyone remembers and show off his calisthenics. Anyway, enjoy the special item now from Kevin.
Falling short when I don't belong. Oh. I am yours, and I believe, oh, I believe what you say of me. I believe, oh, I believe, oh, I believe what you say of me. Oh, I believe.
Thank you, Kevin. Praise God for such a beautiful special item. Now it's time for announcements. So for anyone that has a prayer request, please type in the chat section. Anyone is welcome to share so that we can pray together as a family.
Yep, and tomorrow on the 26th of September, we have a free health talk that's available virtually, and it's on overcoming lockdown fatigue. I know, especially even for me, I get really lazy and I feel really tired every day during lockdown. So it'd be good to join. And yeah, good to see you there as well. So please register through the link that's on the screen if you're interested in joining. And one more announcement is for next Sabbath, we're supposed to have a camp on the long weekend next week. However, it's cancelled due to COVID. So we'll be moving that online, which means that everyone can join in now. However, we're still keeping the theme of the weekend, which is unity, and it's exploring the importance of having meaningful relationships. So next week on the 2nd of October, we'll have an 11 a.m. session on thriving relationships and a 3:30 main service session, which is on meaningful friendships.
Next, for the tithes and offerings, so we do have several options, and on the screens are the details. Please feel free to take a screenshot, or if you have any questions about it, please reach out to any of us. All right, I would like to invite Pastor Tim and Pastor Toppy to lead us in a very special prayer for our very special friend.
Thank you, Beatrice. Yeah, Pastor Toppy, are you there too?
Yes, I'm here.
So Pastor Toppy, and I can't see Pastor Toppy on my screen, but I know he's there. There he is.
All right, I'm there. Finally, I'm there.
And his jar. It's nice to have jar here with us, but it's also a bit sad as well, in the sense that jar will be heading back home to China soon. And but jar, it's been such a blessing having you with us and part of Fountain family for many years now. I was trying to remember how many. Is it about 3.5 or 4?
Since 2018 February. So it's like, how many years?
My math is terrible.
19, 20, 21. 3.5 years would do, I guess.
Okay.
Close to 4. Yes, no, it's been an absolute pleasure to have you with us. Your gentle way of being with us, and just your warm heart. We thank you for having been a gift of God to us for the time that you've been with us. We are sad to see you go.
Thank you. Very blessed to be in the family as well. Yeah, really blessed. Yeah.
Yeah.
I was just thinking too that many of us, when we took a trip across to Adelaide to be a part of Brian and Evie's wedding, we would have seen you at the wedding, but not many of us actually knew you then. And we met you in Sydney. Yeah. So, yeah, it's amazing how God makes connections. I was actually just thinking, Jo, just a verse for you. It was a popular one a few years ago. It was titled the Jabez Prayer, and it's found in 1 Chronicles 4, and I'm just going to read a little bit of it. It just says from verse 10, Jabez cried out to God of Israel, oh, that you would bless me and enlarge my territory. And I was just thinking that first part, Jo, your territory, like as far as friendships and knowledge of learning in your studies, like you came out to Australia to do a master's and then a PhD, which you've now finished. You're now Dr. Jo, Jo. And it's just amazing, though, spiritually, how God has literally, like, taken you from China, brought you to Australia, and just spiritually, just amazing your experience and your witness as well. And now going back to China, how he's extending your territory. And then the last part of that verse just says, let your hand, this is Jabez saying to God, let your hand be with me and keep me from harm. And it's a beautiful thought that God is truly with you no matter where you go. And as a church family, we're all together. And one day we'll be all together permanently. So yeah, just a thought of encouragement, yeah, from Jabez.
Thank you for, it's really nice words, really encouraging. And yeah, thank you.
Thank you. I guess we would like to pray with you that God may be with you while we are apart, while you are there in China. We will always be a family, and that God will continue to lead you and guide you, that you may be a light in those new places where you're going to. Yes.
Yes, thank you.
I wish we were in our little place where we worship, then we would have really prayed with you, but now we have to do it this way. I'll pray, and Pastor Timmy, you'll pray too.
Sure.
Okay, let's pray. Father in heaven, I just want to thank you for many blessings. I want to thank you for the blessing that we get to be such a wonderful and amazing family of people from all walks of life, sometimes even from different backgrounds. It reminds us in our Fountain in the City Church family of the three angels' messages that are supposed to be preached, an everlasting gospel to be preached to every nation, kindred, and tongue. We almost have that in our Fountain in the City Church. We a reflection of how it will be when we get to heaven. But today, Father, we our hearts are sad and yet still proud to see our friend, Jai, that has been with us for almost 3.5 years now. We have gotten to know her, and she has been a blessing to us with her smile, with her gentle spirit and generous gifts that you have given her, her quietness and yet her thoughtfulness. We want to thank you because of all of that, Father. We believe that that was the ministry of the Holy Spirit in her life and through her life to us as we bask in the fire, in the warmth of the fire that you have put within him. So, Father, just want to thank you that as she goes into new horizons, and as my good friend Pastor Tim has put it, that her territory is enlarging. Father, I pray that this territory, as she gets into it, as it enlarges, that you may enlarge her giftedness and her anointing, that she may touch more and more souls for the kingdom through the gifts that you have given him, that she may bring a light into this dark world. As we believe that we live in the last days, here is your daughter who's going to lift up a torch in the workplace where she is at, in the friends that she's going to work. I pray specifically that you will find a healthy group of people that she can commune with spiritually, and that she may continue to grow in those places and also share and serve others. This is my prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Dear God, I want to thank you too for Jar, and just thinking a lot of people know her also as AKA Gia, and she has been such a blessing to us. And God, we just thank you for the fun, the journey, the growth too that we've seen Jar experience and share with us as well in her spiritual journey, and just also to her strong desire to see her family too know you and family and friends back in China, and just her passion to be a witness for you. And I just thank you, God, for how you've placed this desire in her heart. I want to thank you too, God, for giving her a job back in China. And we thank you too, God, for being with her as she prepares to head back to China. I know she's got quite a bit of quarantine time back in China. I pray that time can be a blessing. We thank you, God, that we can still connect through online means, as today this youth program, as many of the youth too are overseas at the moment, and how much of a blessing it is to still connect when we can to each other from even far distances. So God, we thank you once again for Jah. We just thank you for being with her as she heads back home. And we know, God, that she'll enjoy worshiping you. We pray, God, that you'll help her to settle into a new family local home in China, that she can be blessed to and be part of the church body there, even though she's still part of them. But thank you, God. And we just pray that you may protect and keep her safe and those two that she loves and are around her. And God, we just uplift Jah to you. And we just once again thank you for the time that we've had her here in Australia. And we know that it's never goodbye, because we all have the hope of living together with you for eternity. And we love you for that, God. Blessings on Jah. In your name, Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you very much. That's a very beautiful prayer.
Welcome.
Go with God.
Thank you.
So sad to see you go, Jia, but we're also very excited for what the future holds for you and also the path that God leads you to. So we will actually, we'd like everyone to say farewell as well to Jia and give our regards. So we'll have a chance tomorrow on Sunday at 6 p.m. over Zoom. We can all say our little blessings and what we've the connections we've made with her in the past. So hope to see you there tomorrow. And I'd like to invite Sean and Simone for a upcoming workshop event that will be in the coming week.
For that, Clarissa, you spoiled the surprise. Hello, everyone. You know, we've all been very blessed this week after having a whole week of being able to not only connect with old faces for you, new faces for me, to connect with a lot of Fountain youth that are no longer in Australia. And we've not only had that, you know, wonderful opportunity to learn about different aspects of sharing, but all of this is culminating up to this, you know, this amazing youth Sabbath that we have about, you know, the I guess, what sharing is really all about. So Sean, what happens after this? Is this like the end of it? Like, is it just this one week of happiness?
No, so Youth Sabbath is not the end of it all. And Youth Sabbath is in fact actually the beginning of everything. So this week as Fountain Youth, we are, the next few months actually, we're focusing on the theme of sharing. So Youth Sabbath kind of marks the start of this. And so this Living Witness program has really been the start and the lead up to everything that's coming up. So in that, we're actually coming up and sharing with you guys different workshops to help you guys share by exploring practical and personal really methods to help you guys share. So there'll be different topics where you can get to see where you can share and also what you can share. So I guess, you know, that's a little bit of what's coming up. But what is the real purpose and what's the value that we can get out of it tonight?
We've kind of, I guess, where it fits in with everything really is like, you know, in the first quarter, we kind of looked at, you know, the importance of having a personal relationship with God and how having devotions is a fundamental aspect of that. And in the last quarter, we talked about how prayer is also a really important aspect of that. And then here we have sharing. And so, you know, sharing is something that is so multifaceted, as we discovered this week in some of our sharings. You know, we looked at different principles. We're fleshing it a bit more in our sermon today and to see how it sort of fits into the bigger picture. We talked about how it fits into the Great Commission this morning in Brian's video as well. But we wanted to kind of have a practical application, you know, because it's all great to have it all absorbed into you, but we want to put it into action, you know, and we want to make sure everyone, not just the youth, not just Fountain Youth, have the confidence and feel prepared to be able to share. So I guess what's so special about these workshops, Sean? Why are we equipping these people? Like, how are we equipping these people?
Yeah, so I guess, you know, thinking about what's special about these workshops, you know, a lot of sharing is actually being involved in sharing. So usually when we come to workshops, there is a lot of time for us to listen, but there may not be a lot of time for us to share. So a special, I guess, part of this workshop is actually having breakout groups at the end. So what we'll be doing is we'll have a speaker who is actually a guest speaker. So we have, you know, different exciting people from different professions, from different backgrounds who will be coming to share their experience of sharing in the different topics that we'll be sharing about very soon. But yeah, there'll be breakout sessions at the end where you can actually learn from each other and digest what you guys are learning and also come up with ways to apply it. And so each workshop will also have a really, really cool challenge. So then, you know, what you learn, you can put it into practice and then also like see that effect happen. And, you know, sometimes it can be hard to actually experience sharing because we may be not know how to exactly go about it. So these challenges will kind of give a framework for you guys to actually follow, and that'll make things easier and give you guys confidence and direction as well.
So
I guess what are some of the topics and times, and when is all this happening and what is it about?
You know, we want to make sure that there is not too big of a gap between Youth Sabbath and like the happiness and the joy of Youth Sabbath and when these workshops start. So they're actually starting really soon. And our first one is coming on the 9th of October, and we're starting at 10:30 in the morning. And we're kicking it off with our first one, which is called Sharing Your Story, which is all about sharing your personal testimony. Because, you know, as we learned from this week, sharing is really based on your personal relationship with God, based on, you know, your testimony and your story. And what makes this so awesome is that each and every one of us have a completely different story. So we'll be having guest speakers to tell us how we can share our story. Following that, on the 23rd of October, which is another 2 weeks after that, is we'll be learning about sharing on the job. And what that actually means is, you know, a lot of us rub shoulders with a lot of people. For those of you who have come to our Wednesday live session, you will know that a lot of the people that were giving testimonies actually had a lot of opportunities to share in the workplace. And so we're going to be doing a workshop on how you can share in your workplace. Most of us predominantly work in non-believing sort of setting. And so how do we kind of navigate those work relationships? These are people that we spend 8-9 hours with, maybe online now, not physically. So yeah, we're going to be learning how we're going to do that. To be doing that. And the most exciting thing, I think, is that this is all online, which means it doesn't matter where you are. So who's invited, Sean? Is this just for youth? Is this just restricted to youth?
I think one of my favorite things about these workshops is actually it's an open invite. So it's not just for Fountain Youth. It's not just for Fountain in the City Church. It's actually for anyone and everyone who you want to invite. So invite your friends, invite your friends from other churches, invite your family overseas, especially to make use of this time that we're online. It will be a blessing. So the link and more details will be shared on our Facebook pages and also on our WhatsApp group chat. So please let everyone know that this is happening, and we would love to have you guys join and share and learn with you guys. So that is essentially what's coming up, and hope that is really encouraging you guys to join in as well.
All right, thank you, Sean and Simone, for the invitation for the workshop. Now, all the way from Germany, Eric will lead us in a congregational prayer, and also to pray for all the prayer requests on the chat section.
Let us bow our heads to pray. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you very much that we can come together as a global family, not just Fountain in the Sea, but that we also, through the technology and everything, that we can join all together and focus on you. And we're in this congregation. We want to invite your Holy Spirit, that it may be with us, that it may open our hearts, that we dedicate ourselves to you and to the speakers. Lord, I also want to uplift the prayer requests that have been delivered, which you bring here, because we come here because you are a living fountain. You are the actual fountain of life. And we go to you because we know you are the source of all the goodness that is coming into this world. And in this matter, I want to lift up the health of Luz to you, that you may be with her, and also other people that are struggling with COVID-19, which are in the hospital bed, which are very uncertain about what's to happen, about the current legislations that are on the way. Lord, be with everyone who's affected by the virus in whichever country they are and the uncertainties they face. Lord, I also pray for Eva. I pray for her engineering job, that she may keep it for many years to come, and that that you may accompany her on a way to being a senior engineer, that her work will always be in a good light, that you will be there in every case when she faces a challenge. You know how it is when being an engineer, that there are multiple challenges. If it's not technical, it may be on a personal basis where you struggle with other employees. Lord, be with her. And I also pray for Miroslava's family health, that you be with her family, that you may protect her family from all the things that could harm them, including the virus. And I also want to pray for Ferretti Lillo, that you may be with him during COVID as well. Lord, you know, there are also many more people who come here to church, to this virtual church, but into your spirit, where we are hoping to get a glimpse of what your kingdom is like, and also be with all the others that have worries on their hearts that did not dare to utter them, that you may hear their voices and receive their prayer requests. And as we are heading into our divine service, also be with our speakers, be with Kelly, be with Stanley, that we may receive their message, that you may open our hearts, that we may be changed through the messages, and that we can forward it in our daily lives to others and show them your wonderful light, that it may shine into their lives, and that we may bring life and light into the cities around ourselves, and that you may make an example of us, that you may enlarge in us. In Jesus' name I pray, amen.
Happy Sabbath, everyone. It's good to be able to join you all today despite being in Indonesia. The main verse for today is found in the book of Matthew, chapter 25, verse 21. The Bible says, "His Lord said to him, 'Well done, good and faithful servant. You are faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of your Lord.'" Thank you. Thank you, Eric. Thank you, Vanessa. Now we have a lovely lady whose smile always permeated the room when she walked in. We have the beautiful Evie all the way from Perth to present us our next special item. Thank you.
Thank you, Abby. Such a beautiful song. So, Clarissa, before we hear from our first speaker, do you know who it is?
Yes, of course I know her. The tour to Sydney, from the Art Gallery of New South Wales, all the way to Chinatown for 1 litre of bubble tea. That was no joke.
It actually sounds fun. I remember we actually met up and then took a photo together in Chinatown.
Oh, yes, I remember that too. So, Kelly. Hi, Kelly. How are you? Do you remember our walk?
Yes, I do. It was such an excruciating walk. I almost died, but that 1 liter of bubble tea was so worth it.
I agree.
So, Kelly, what's something fun or new you've been doing during lockdown?
Okay. So I think a few of us, many of us are doing this 10K challenge, walking challenge in September. So I think that walking has become part of my personality now. So I'm really praise God. I think, you know, walking, I get to exercise, you know, get those endorphins and also get to spend some time in prayer and listening to podcasts too.
Ooh, sounds fun. I also do a little bit of walking, so that's very healthy of you. Awesome. Well, we can't wait to hear from you. So I'll let you take it away. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay. I'll just wait for Randy for my slides, I think. Or we don't need to do that yet. Yep. So before, I just want to start off by really thanking everyone who shared this past week in the devotional videos on the Fountain Youth group chat. Really praise God for your testimonies. It was really encouraging and inspiring to hear. And I hope that everyone who tuned in is also blessed there too. So just before I start, let's say a word of prayer. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, thank you so much for your Sabbath day. And thank you that we can all be here together, Lord, and be able to worship you and come together in this as well. Lord, just want to pray that you be with me today, especially. Please anoint my lips and really be with me as I share your word, Lord. And may you really speak through me and that you may be glorified as well. Lord, thank you so much for listening to my prayer. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay. So, Randy, let me try if this works. Randy, it's not working. Can you just click next, please? Thank you. All right. Okay. So if you know me, you know that one of my current favorite things right now to eat is mala, and that's Chinese stir fry hot pot, which is in the picture, right? And my favorite mala restaurant is Mala 1+1 in Melbourne, which is in the picture. But spoiler alert, it closed down this year, which is really sad, but that's okay, right? So the first time I tried it, the flavor was intense. It was addicting, and I instantly fell in love. Kept going back, told all my friends about my new find and my experience. And it's the same, right? When we truly experience Jesus, we taste his goodness, how he's changed our lives for the better. And we fall so much in love with him that we can't help but go to other people and share to others around us. Next slide, please. Okay, yeah. So similar to the Samaritan woman at the well, right? I'm sure most of you are familiar with this. So it was her first encounter with Jesus. And then what happened after that, right? She left her water pot. She left what she was doing and she went to town to tell others about him. And let's see what she says in verse 29. Come see a man who told me all things that I ever did, right? Could this be the Christ? So what did she say? What did she talk about? She didn't share these really convoluted topics, biblical doctrines about like, do you know the Jerusalem? Is Jerusalem better to worship in? But she simply said, come and see a man who told me all these things I ever did. She talked about her experience with Christ. And you know, you may not be able to share a full-fledged Bible study or do a sermon series, you know, but you can always share about what you have experienced with this man, this Jesus. Click, next slide, please. Yeah, so in Acts 4, verse 20, it says, for we cannot but speak the things which we have seen and heard. So God's just calling for us to share about the things we have experienced, right? The things we've seen, the things we've heard in our walk with him on a firsthand basis. Yeah, so I grew up in a Christian home, the Adventist home. And, you know, growing up, I always knew, like, you know, sharing is really good. It's something that we're all encouraged to do, right?
you always hear, I always hear at least that it's all, witnessing is important, you should do it. And I always know it's a good thing, but why is it so important? So while preparing for this short sermonette, I made three drafts, and in each draft, God revealed so many things to me, and I'd love to share all of them, all of the things I learned with you, but I can't do that in 15 minutes. So I'm going to talk about just one point that really spoke to me the most, and that's when we share about Jesus, when we point to him, when we bring others to him. In the process, we can also grow in our own faith and become more like Jesus. You know, in the process, we grow in our faith. And that's something that I didn't realize or that I forgot about when I was working on my first draft. So I really praise God for revealing that to me. Next slide, please. Okay, click again. Only once, yeah. So we all know the Great Commission, right? It's real, these are really famous words. But have you ever noticed that the Great Commission is found in all four Gospels? Next slide. Just click once. Here. Yes. So Matthew, right? Go therefore and make disciples of all nations. And Mark, go into all the world, preach the gospel. And Luke, you're witnesses. And John, I also send you. All right. So have you ever stopped to wonder, like, why do all the gospels end with this, right? Repetition must be important. And it's something that each gospel could not leave out. So why do they all end with this? Is it because just repeating a commandment that, you know, Jesus really wants us to share and we need to share because he commands us to? Well, maybe, right? But whenever God tells us to do something, there's always a good reason behind it, right? And one that's good for us. You know, it's like when my mom tells me to stop eating so many sugary foods, stop drinking bubble tea so much, go get some exercise, go get some sunlight, right? It's for my own benefit. You know, when God gives us the health laws or tells us like not to murder people or like to honor our parents, there's a reason and it's good for our own benefit as well. And, or is it repeated because God wants us to finish the work? He needs us to finish the work and spread the gospel. Next slide, please. Next slide, please. Yep. Thank you. Yeah. So in Romans 9:28, it says, for he will finish the work and cut it short in righteousness, because the Lord will make a short work upon the earth, right? So he will finish the work. We don't finish the work, but God does. But in saying that, God gives us the honor, the privilege of taking part in finishing the work to spread the gospel. Next slide, please. Right, in Desire of Ages, it says that God could have reached his object in saving sinners without our aid. When I read this, I was like, what, really? It does make sense though, right? Because God could have used other ways to reach people, and he has. You know, whether that can be in visions, in dreams, angels, or other methods, right? But he chose to give us this privilege to be a part of it. And what does it say next? But in order for us to develop a character like Christ's, we must share in his work. In order for us to develop a character to be more like Jesus, God gives us this privilege to be able to take part in sharing and spreading the gospel. All right. So in doing this, we can develop a character more like Christ and can grow in our faith. So who in your midst can you share with? Who has God placed in your life specifically that only you can reach, or in a way, like human agencies, only you can reach people in your life who don't, like, for example, I have this, I've got a grandmother and she's Buddhist, right? And she isn't doing the best physically right now. So she's at home for a while. And every week she only sees me, when I'm at home, that's in Thailand, she sees me, she sees my mom, she sees my dad, she sees her caretaker. And when she goes out, she sees a doctor, right? So who can reach her if not me, not my family, okay? Next slide, please. So let's take a quick look. Next slide. Yeah, let's take a quick look at the parable of the talent. So I just wanna just quick recap, since we are, maybe most of us are familiar with the story. So the master goes on a journey and he gives his servants talents according to their abilities, right? So what can talents mean? You know, I've heard many interpretations. Talents can mean things that God's given us, whether that's time, whether that's money or abilities. But could it also mean the gift or the ability of sharing about God, or just, you know, having that knowledge and that experience with Jesus that we can share about? Right. So as we know, the ones who are given, the servants who are given 5 talents, the ones who are given 2 talents, they used them and they doubled them. And what did the master say in the key verse that Vanessa read? His Lord said to him, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things, and I will make you ruler over many things," right? So he gave him more, right? So when you use it, more is given to you. And next slide, please. And what about the one who hid his talent? It was taken away from him, right? It was taken away from him. Have you ever heard this before? You know, like the phrase, use it or lose it. Next slide, please. So in 7th grade, I really like swinging. So I was in 7th grade, I was swinging on the swings like normal, and I jumped off, and as I usually do, but this time I fractured my arm. And you know, like when the cast comes off, right? What happens? The muscles that were in the cast weren't being used. So they lose muscle tone, they lose muscle mass, and they become small and weak compared to the muscle of the other arm that's being used, right? So you use it or you lose it. So do you share, do you hide your talent of sharing like the man with the 1 talent had, or do you use it to bring glory to God? And you know, when you use it, you can grow your faith muscle, grow your faith in God, and grow closer to him as well. Next slide, please. Okay, so just before I close, just wanna share a bit of my story as well. So I truly believe that when I share, my faith muscle really grows, and this really helps me to draw closer to God as well. You know, when I share or prepare to share, whether that's to others or in Sabbath school, in care group, really praise God that I receive such a blessing and that I grow in my faith. And there was one time that I specifically remember when I was sharing in care group around 2 years ago, around this time of the year. So back then I was in Melbourne, I was in my final year. I was about to graduate from uni, and I was really, really struggling with my uncertain future. And the topic I was going to share about was about Gideon. And since I had to share about this Bible character, I really dived into the Bible, meditated on the verses, prayed, really asked for the Holy Spirit and wisdom. And this is way more than what I would do if I had just come to care group, you know, and just like listen to someone else talking, or, you know, when I listen to a sermon, it's just really passive listening, right? Sometimes. And even more when it came time to prepare a short testimony about my walk with God, right? I had to really think about it. I recounted the blessings, like how God led me in the past, in the little steps from in high school, how God led me, you know, and like to the university, to the church in Melbourne, and the little ways that he was working in my life. And it made me realize in that period of uncertainty, how much faith I was lacking, and how I was trying to rely on myself instead of relying in him. And preparing for the sharing, it really reminded me on how God led Gideon, and despite all the odds, how the odds were against them, that God was the one in charge. It wasn't Gideon, and it certainly wasn't me. So God used this experience of preparing and sharing to draw me closer to him and really reaffirm my faith that he will guide me through. And just thinking about and while preparing, you know, thinking about the experience and then preparing, reading the word and saying it out loud again to other people, it really reaffirmed my faith and my belief. And what I mean by that, you know, it's like a similar process to when I translate out loud. So I've done some translating from Thai to English before. So the first time I hear it, right, I hear it in Thai, someone says something in Thai, and then I have to think about it. And then when I translate in English, it comes out, right? And I hear myself saying it again. So the first time I have to think about it, I hear it one time. And then when I say it again, it comes out another time. So it really enforces the content. And you know, when I share about my experience with Jesus, I first reflect on how God has worked in my life. And then when I share to someone else, I hear myself saying it again out loud. And it really strengthens my faith, I think, and draws me closer to God as well. Next slide. So I wonder, Randy's our next slide. Thank you. I really wonder, you know, the Samaritan woman that we read about in the first part of my sharing. I wonder if she, every time, you know, when she shared her story, did she remember back to that experience, that encounter that she had with Jesus, you know? Did it help her grow in her faith? Was she blessed by it over and over again every time she recounted her experience with Jesus to other people? So you can grow and you can make your muscles stronger and closer to God when you share your faith, right? God has given us the Great Commission in all four Gospels, not because he needs us to finish the work, but he's given us this privilege, you know, this honor to take part in it. And in the process of sharing, in the process of spreading this word, he's given us the opportunity to also grow in character, to be more like him. And so you don't share in order to be blessed, right? You share because you can't help but contain the joy, like the Samaritan woman, right? And you want to bring glory to God. But in doing that, you can also be really blessed and grow in your faith and to become more connected with God as well. So will you use the knowledge, your experience with Christ and the privilege of sharing to grow in faith and character? Or will you lose it like the man who hid his God-given talent? No, that's all. Thank you.
Thank you.
has given us the ability to share and grow our character through sharing and to use our talents that God has given us. So
I agree. After hearing Kelly's sermon, it makes me even more excited to hear from our second speaker.
Yes, it's the one and only Stanley.
I remember when I did MC in Youth Sabbath before, Stanley was also one of the speakers, and he is one of the speakers again today. It's been a while, and I'm excited to hear from him again.
Yes, Stanley has been a really great friend and youth leader in Fountain to me, and also I'm very excited to hear from him again. So hi, Stanley. I know you were just about to speak, but could you give us a little spoiler of what you're talking about today?
Okay. I guess it's going to be very similar to what Kelly was sharing, and we're talking about the importance of sharing, and really why we share is when we share it really helps us to not only to be a blessing to others, but it brings a blessing to ourselves as well. So it gives us a lot of joy. That's a little spoiler.
Thank you, Stanley. I can't wait to hear more about it. I'll hand it over to you.
All right, thank you. Just trying to share. All right. Happy Sabbath, everyone. And it's good to be here. And it's good to be able to share today with all of you as well. Thank you also, Kelly, for sharing the first bit. And it was really a blessing to hear and to listen to some of the stories that you shared. And thank you also for the special item, very encouraging. And also to help us to share our faith to the people around us. So before we start, we're gonna open again with a word of prayer. Father in heaven, Lord, we just want to come to you again today, just as we go into the second part of this talk, Lord, that you may be with us. Help me also, Lord, to be able to share the message that you want me to share today, Lord. May it come across really well, and that it may be a blessing and an encouragement to all of us as well, Lord, as we as you have sent us to share as well to the people around us. So be with us, Lord. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. So when we talk about sharing in general, most of the time it is it has a positive connotation, right? And it generates a positive impact. When we share whatever it might be, it can be food, as Kelly shared before. It can also be knowledge. It can be money, or it can be time. It would usually leave you with a great feeling, a feeling of satisfaction. And as a church family this year, we are very blessed to be able to have and to experience some of these opportunities. We were able to give food to homeless people around the city. We were able to donate blood. We were able to help to cook and to give food to the people in the community. Some of us as well are able to help students through online study buddy, or even recently, and it's still going now, we were able to make donations to ADRA through Fountain Footstep. So for those of you that are able to participate in some of these initiatives, how did this make you feel? I don't know about you, but for me personally, I felt really good. Yes, sometimes it can be tiring. Sometimes it can be exhausting. Sometimes it can take a lot of time from us. But, you know, deep inside, I feel that I was satisfied. I feel I'm happy. I feel really blessed, especially, you know, when you see the impact that it made in people's life. And it's no different from sharing Jesus. It's no different from sharing your testimony with other people. Sharing your experience with Jesus can also bring that joy. And that is another reason why sharing is important. So continuing from Kelly, that's what I'm going to talk about today, that sharing brings you joy. So remembering from the parable of the talent that Kelly just shared with us earlier, after the master came back and saw, he saw the two servants multiplied what he had entrusted to them, right? And he said, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You were faithful over a few things. I will make you ruler over many things. Enter into the joy of the Lord." So enter into the joy of the Lord. What is it? What does that really mean? From the book Steps to Christ, it really explained this really well. It says that in page 77, it says, "Our Savior's joy was in the uplifting and redemption of fallen men." So the joy of God is really to see his children coming to him and to be saved. And who else are rejoicing when people come and connect with Jesus? It says in Luke 15, verse 10, it says, "Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents." So so the angels are also joining God in this joyful event whenever a soul comes to God. So whenever someone comes to Jesus, the heaven are rejoicing. And so when we talk about entering into the joy of the Lord, how do we enter into that joy? Just like the angels. It says from the Desire of Ages, this part was also used by Kelly earlier. The second part of it, it says, "In order to enter into his joy, the joy of seeing souls redeemed by his sacrifice, we must participate in his labor for their redemption." So how do we experience that joy? We are to participate in his labor as well. So sharing what Jesus really means to us, being a living witness and helping others see Jesus, is how we can experience the joy of the Lord. And I really like that part there highlighted in red. It says, we must participate in his labor. It means that we're not alone in this. You know, it's saying that we're not the only one that is doing the work. We are co-workers together with God and the angels. And in fact, you know, we're probably the last member that actually joined this team, right? God and the angels were already doing this work even before we started. So I want you to listen to this powerful thought as well, and from Steps to Christ, chapter 79. It says that, "And the efforts to bless others will react in blessings upon ourselves. This was the purpose of God in giving us a part to act in the plan of redemption." So as Kelly said as well before, what was really the purpose of God sending us to share? really it is for our own benefit. It's for, as we bless others, we are also being blessed. And it says here, he has granted men the privilege of becoming partakers of the divine nature, and in their turn, of diffusing blessings to their fellow men. It continues, this is the highest honor, the greatest joy that it is possible for God to bestow upon men. Those who thus become participants in labors of love are brought nearest to their creator. Wow, powerful, right? It says, so the purpose why God really wants us to be a part of his work is, number one, as Kelly mentioned, it can draw us closer to him. It can grow our faith. And secondly, so that we can experience the highest honor and the greatest joy from doing so. So for those of you that joined our live session on Wednesday evening, I'm sure you know what I'm talking about. And we were blessed by a lot of speakers at that day, but in particularly, we listened to the story that was shared by Andy and Raf. They shared their experience of sharing to their friends back when they were in Doha. So it was a really, really powerful story. And it started from one person sharing Jesus to Andy. So, and Andy got baptized. And then Andy shared to Raf, and Raf got baptized. And then from then, Raf was a part of this a group that trains together on the weekend. And after their training, they always invited them to their house to have breakfast. And also they would share Jesus then. And from that experience alone, there were around 7 to 8 people that ended up having a real experience with Jesus. And as they were sharing this story, you can just see it from their face, the joy and the excitement that beams as they shared that story. So that is just one example, right, of what sharing can bring into our life, the highest honor and the greatest joy. So going back to that last quote, it says that God has granted men the privilege of becoming partakers of the divine nature. Friends, sharing and being a living witness for God is not a duty. It's not a responsibility, but rather a privilege and a gift from God. The question for us now is, when God presents us an opportunity and a privilege to share, what do we do about it? Do we run away? Do we and shy away? Or do we actually embrace and accept that gift from God? So just the last quote for today. It's found in Still Steps to Christ, page 79. It says that God might have committed the message of the gospel and all the work of loving ministry to the heavenly angels. He might have employed other means of accomplishing his purpose, but in his infinite love, he chose to make us co-workers with himself, with Christ and the angels. Why? That we might share the blessing, the joy, the spiritual uplifting, which results from this unselfish ministry. Imagine God in heaven in the midst of all the angels, right? And he said to them, you know, I know that you all love doing this work. You know, you all love working for the soul of the people on the earth and receiving that joy. But do we really want to keep that joy just to ourselves? Why don't we share it with them as well? Let's bring them into the team. I want them also to be able to have the opportunity to share and to experience the joy that comes as a result. Friends, why is sharing important? Because God loves us and He wants to share that joy with us. And if we want to take that sharing from God, we are to share and to participate in His work. So the next question is, so we've developed that, okay. When we share, God can give us that joy. So the next question is, can we share and see others come to Jesus and still don't receive that joy? Yes, we can. And notice in the last sentence of that quote, it says that we might share the blessing, the joy, the spiritual uplifting, which results from what? From unselfish ministry. When we share with a motive that is other than unselfishness, we most likely won't be able to experience that joy. As an example, just to kind of illustrate what this principle, we have two Bible characters. They were both successful witnesses for God, but they have two different attitudes. These are Jonah and Paul. So I'm going to go with Jonah first. So Jonah witnessed to the whole city of Nineveh, right? And God converted it all. Yet, seeing the whole city actually came to God and repented did not make him happy. He was not excited at all. In fact, he was actually angry at God. His self-centeredness was so bad that he actually felt ashamed. He felt silly because he was sharing about the destruction of the city, and that did not happen. In chapter 4, verse 3, he actually said to God, "Therefore now, O Lord, please take away my life from me, for it is better for me to die than to live." So we see here from Jonah that, yes, it is possible. If we don't have the right attitude, if we don't have the right motives, we can actually miss that joy from seeing other people come to Jesus. And in contrast, we have Paul, you know, this selfless guy. For the sake of the gospel, he endured persecutions, he endured prison, he endured, being shipwrecked, and many, many, many more. He always put the interests of others before him. And I found this really cool verse in 1 Thessalonians 2, verse 19 and 20. It says, he said, "For what is our joy? What is our hope or joy? Our crown of rejoicing, is it not even you in the presence of our Lord Jesus Christ at his coming? For you are our glory and joy." Friends, when our sharing is driven by our love for God and our love for other people, we will surely experience that joy of God. So just to end today, I want to quickly share a little experience that I have. So I was privileged enough to witness someone that is dear to me being baptized 2 years ago. Right? She's my fiance. I hope I'm not embarrassing her too much. It was a long story, a long journey. You know, a lot of prayers, a lot of sharing happened. And it was such a special day. And I can't begin to describe the joy that God allowed me to experience that day, right? But you know what? That was not the end. Fiona may not know this because I probably haven't told her, but seeing her continue to walk with God, seeing God continue to teach, to mold, and to transform her life. And even now she becomes very involved and active in a ministry that continue to give sparks of joy in me. And as I was preparing this message, I realized that, yes, it is very true. You know, the opportunity for us to share Jesus, seeing the person that you shared with actually get it, you know, and seeing God continues to transform their lives is the highest honor and the greatest joy that God can give us. So friends, I hope and pray that as individuals and as a church, we can really accept that privilege from God, the privilege of sharing and the privilege of being a living witness for Jesus. And if you want to accept that, I want to invite you to the series of workshops that were announced by Sean and Simone earlier. Come and learn practical ways to be able to help us share. And I also want to challenge all of us, and this includes myself, at the end of your time with God daily, that we may be able to ask him, Lord, help me open my eyes in my daily life for more opportunities to share and to be a living witness to someone, and give me the power to do so. So let's pray together. Dear Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you so much, Lord, for being with us today. Thank you for this week as well, as we journey through the theme of being a living witness. Thank you, Lord, for reminding us the importance of having a relationship with you and the importance of sharing as well. How sharing with others would be able not only to help them to come close to you, but also to help us to be able to come closer to you as well. Thank you also, Lord, for the privilege that you have given to us to be co-workers with you, so that we can experience that entering into the joy of the Lord. Lord, open our eyes so we can see those opportunities you are giving to us. Give us power to be your living witness in this world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you, Stanley, for sharing the joy that we can feel and the impact that we can have to not only ourselves, but also to others through sharing. But so sad to say that our youth Sabbath is ending. I've been having such a great time listening to beautiful sermons, special items, and seeing so many familiar faces.
Yes, me too, but that's okay. We have next Sabbath to look forward to, also the workshops to look forward to, and hopefully the next youth Sabbath we can be virtual, or if it's in person, even better. Thank you so much to all the participants today and everyone here. We appreciate each one of you.
Yes, definitely. I hope everyone enjoys the youth Sabbath as much as we do.
Yep, and before we leave, we just want to remind you of recurring virtual activities in case you miss us too much. So you're able to join us for care groups every Friday evening at 6:30 p.m. or 7 p.m. over Zoom currently. Also, we have our Bible study groups every Sabbath with each of your respective classes. Please reach out to any one of us if you would like more detail or if you're interested in joining.
Also, a reminder that we have a special program at 11 a.m. and 3:30 p.m. next Sabbath on the 2nd of October. So I hope you all can make it.
Okay, amazing. And I hope everyone feels blessed from the program. Also, anyone who's on Zoom, feel free to stay back But whoever is watching live, I hope you have a good week ahead. See you.